CS.
Welcome to the Pop-Tarts Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Mania. Pour some sugary goodness on it. We've got an edible mascot, and we've got two ranked teams. We're in Orlando, Florida at Camping World Stadium, where NC State tries to win 10 games for the first time since 2002, and the second time in school history. Kansas State turns to a star freshman today. We're buttered, we're toasted, we are ready for consumption. And Ishraf, Andre Ware, Paul Carcaterra will be with us in just a moment. For the Wolfpack, Andre, this they are calling a legacy game.
Yeah, they are. They're the first time in a long time, only the second time in program history, they can win 10 games. And so what does that do? It sets them up for next year in terms of recruiting, as well as where would they start the season ranked with a 12-team playoff on the horizon.
And for NC State, their journey this season has mirrored the journey of their quarterback, Brennan Armstrong. We'll get to that after the opening kickoff. NC State will kick it away. Kansas State will receive. And the Wolfpack will take it out at the 25-yard line, and we say hello to Paul Carcaterra.
Hello, Anish. Avery Johnson, the freshman quarterback from Kansas State. You hear the Kansas State faithful. He's played a lot of snaps, but he's never made a start until tonight. We spoke this week. He said this first snap is so meaningful for him, and he can't wait to be with his team and lead this offense. Everyone talks about his legs, rightfully so. Maybe the fastest player on the team, 21 miles per hour on the GPS. But when you talk to offensive coordinator Connor Riley, he said he's a pure passer and spins the rock.
He is a true freshman, one of the biggest recruits in the history of the program. And this is first start as a quarterback. And on first down, he hands it off to the 1,100-yard back, DJ Giddens, who's coming off three straight 100-yard games.
Yeah, you want to take some pressure off a young player, especially a quarterback. He's got to have a guide behind him, and DJ Givens, or like DJ Givens, to kind of alleviate the start to this bowl game for him. Talented youngster in Avery Johnson. Paul told you he can spin it, he can run. Everybody on the offense believes they can win with this young man under center.
They'll feed it to Giddens again, who machetes through the heart of that NC State defense. A gain of 13 more, and it's a Wolfpack defense, Andre, as the umpire gets tangled up. They're missing the best defensive player in college football in Peyton Wilson.
They are, you know, a guy that can play sideline to sideline. And on the other side, Kansas State has all five starters on the offensive line. Nobody, and I mean nobody, opted out, including the All-American Cooper Beebe.
Giddens again, able to squirm free, and turns that into a 5-yard pickup.
They have decided that they are going to take the approach of riding DJ Giddens here early. And I mean, turn it over to the big offensive line of Kansas State, and they're opening some holes. And a lot of that run, though, Anish, was all Giddens.
First throw of the game for Johnson, going downfield for the freshman Brown, who had a step, and it's overthrown. Aiden White, the all-conference corner, in coverage. And now Avery Johnson has not thrown more than 10 passes in a game this season, but the coaching staff said, we know that what he's put on film is mostly with his legs.
Yeah.
Believe us, this guy's got a real arm, and he can do damage with the cannon.
It was on display there, just a little bit overthrown for Jace Brown, who is another guy who really came on the second half of the season at receiver for Kansas State. It started the last five games, and tell you what, the future is bright in Manhattan, Kansas.
On third down here is Giddens, ran into a brick wall right at the line of scrimmage. No gain. It was Sean Brown, the hard-hitting safety. And fourth down with an early decision for this K-State offense, which, by the way, has a different play caller. Connor Riley is the acting offensive coordinator. He had been the O-line coach. Colin Klein, their OC, went and took the same job at Texas A&M.
That explains why there's so many runs here early in this game when you have an O-line coach. You know, he is going to depend on the guys up front, but 20 times this year they've gone for it on fourth down, converting 50% of it.
NC State has been superb on defense, especially down the stretch. And Tony Gibson's scheme, they like to bring pressure. Here's a lot of pressure. Giddens on the leak out. Touchdown! Kansas State.
No hesitation whatsoever on the part of Avery Johnson. The young freshman quarterback knew exactly where the blitz was coming from, where he could beat it, and he found DJ Giddens for the first points of this ball game. I mean, he is going to stare the blitz down. He knew once the edge rusher came off, Giddens was going to be free, floats one with great touch into his running back's hands, and Giddens does the rest.
How much of that, Andre, was pre-snap blitz recognition?
Oh, it's all there. That's exactly where it came from. Knowing where the pressures come from, this staff went down to NC State and spent some time before the season in terms of learning their defense, and they know exactly what the looks come from. You see it coming off the edge. Giddens is going to release outside, and a nice touch pass by Avery Johnson. I mean, knew exactly where it was coming from. The touch on the ball, everything you wanted. Well, that'll build a little confidence, won't it?
Sure will. He had 5 rushing touchdowns, Avery Johnson did, in a win against Texas Tech this year. That's his 4th passing touchdown. The last time a true freshman started a bowl game for Kansas State, you got to go back to the 2006 Texas Bowl when it was Josh Freeman, who, by the way, ended up becoming a first-round pick.
Yeah, he did. And he could sling it around. You talk about a big-time arm, Josh Freeman, and this kid has got all the tools, the arm talent, the legs to go with it, one of the fastest players in the program, as you mentioned. Kansas State has scored on their opening drive 10 times this season, 9 of them for touchdowns.
37 yards, Johnson to Giddens. NC State has a couple of dangerous return men. Here is Julian Gray. And K-State, with special teams, cuts down Gray inside the 10. The quarterback for NC State, it's Brennan Armstrong. He was a standout at Virginia, where Robert and I was his offensive coordinator. Struggled last year without an eye. Transferred to NC State, where Anai was the OC. Struggled early in the season, was benched. When he was benched, he lost his job, but won the locker room. When MJ Morris, who had supplanted him, said, "Hey, I want a red shirt. I'm not playing any more games," Armstrong came back in, and he led this team to 3 wins down the stretch. NC State finished the year on a 5-game win streak.
Credit to Armstrong for sticking it out. Most guys would have kind of gone into, you know, curled up, wanting to, you know, pout. He stuck it out, and boy, has he benefited from it. Look, and the run here, that's what he's all about. It's almost like a 6-foot, 215-pound linebacker who can throw the football. That's Brennan Armstrong. Tough, physical. They love to use him in the running game, but don't get it twisted. He can beat you with his arm as well.
He's the team's leading rusher. Interestingly enough, the 2nd leading rusher for NC State is a wide receiver, the freshman KC Concepcion, who we expect to be a big focal point tonight.
You're going to see this all through bowl season. A lot of youngsters getting opportunities.
True freshman Kendrick Raphael from Naples, Florida, tackled at the line of scrimmage. Andre, like a lot of teams in bowl season, both of these teams have had to deal with a lot of opt-outs with K-State. Yeah. We mentioned the O-line is intact, skill positions, quarterback, a lot of new faces there. NC State has lost a lot of depth, especially at the running back position.
And on defense, with their best player in the program, and Peyton Wilson, sitting this one out. He's here, was out on the field for warm-ups, but elected not to participate in this bowl game.
By all accounts, he wanted to play and was told, "Listen, you got a bright future ahead of you. No need to risk injury." Quarterback draw for Armstrong. This scares K-State. That was their big worry. Armstrong running north and south. B.J. Payne gets in there to make the tackle, and it's 3rd and long.
Yeah, talking to the K-State defensive coaches, Joe Klanderman, their D coordinator, he said, "Hey, what concerns us? They're multiple on offense. You're going to see a lot of different looks from NC State, a lot of different formations, and the quarterback, he's a player, especially in the run game on the draw plate." They were ready in that instance. Here comes pressure, and got a little motion, a little false start by the right side of NC State's offensive line.
False start. Offense, number 54. 5-yard penalty, 3rd down.
A Now, this was an offensive line after a loss to Duke, which put the Wolfpack at 4-3. They had to move some pieces. Now, the big one was Tim McKay moving from right tackle to right guard, and they moved Jacarius Peak to right tackle. Peak was the MVP of the O-line. They've been much better running the football. They've been much better in protection. They've changed some of what they do with tempo. First catch by Concepcion, and he gets to about the original line of scrimmage. Jacob Parrish cuts him down, and we'll get our first punt from Caden Neumkester.
Yeah, Parrish is the first one to arrive on the doorstep of Concepcion, but you're going to see Marquise Siegel just kind of shadow the young freshman. A lot of respect for Concepcion, the way he has really played and matured throughout the season, has become their lead wide receiver, young and talented, but Siegel is their best cover man on the back end.
Neumkester kicks this one away. Fair catch is called for, and it is made inside the 40. K-State missing Phillip Brooks, who opted out. A punt return ace. Wildcats with the lead and the football. Welcome back to the Pop-Tarts Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Mania. Still more bowl games tonight coming up at 9:15 Eastern.
Good one.
Here on ESPN. Yes, sir. We cap off for bowl four-pack with 14th-ranked Arizona and number 12 Oklahoma.
Up-and-coming Arizona.
That's right. In the Valero Alamo Bowl, soon to be Big 12-bound Arizona.
They got two of the best backs I've seen all year and two of the best linebackers I've seen all year at Arizona. Good football team. Be a challenge for Oklahoma in that one.
Kansas State with a 7-0 lead after scoring on its opening drive. On the fly sweep, falling down is Keegan Johnson, the Iowa transfer. He's finally healthy. He'd been banged up early in the season.
Yeah.
Coach is telling us he was never quite right, but this time off here in bowl season has given him a time and a chance to heal up.
Yeah, he can keep a defense honest with his speed. He can threaten you deep, and trying to get him involved on a fly sweep there, but just a little bit too quick. The footwork wasn't matching what was between the ears.
Johnson, quick throw, right back to Johnson. And his hit hard by Shaheen Battle, the all-conference corner. So that was Avery Johnson to Keegan Johnson, and it's third down.
Kansas State, they're 8-1 when scoring first this season. Big stat there, because it gives you a lot of confidence going forward. Want to get points in your back pocket early. They were able to do it on their opening drive.
Wildcats lost a lot of depth in the backfield and at receiver. Veteran offensive line, though, one of the best in the nation. Johnson on the move, his eyes still upfield, directing traffic, fires a laser off the hands of Porter.
Gotta
catch that. And it's incomplete, fourth down.
Gotta have that one. Seth Porter's gotta come up with that. He's only had two catches on the season with one touchdown. But this one, just kind of getting off script as the youngster, eyes down the field. You see exactly why this coaching staff is so high on Avery Johnson. He's got some stuff that you just can't coach.
Now, that's a spot, especially with a guy of Johnson's pedigree, you might expect him to take off.
Exactly.
He wanted to make a play with his arm.
Eyes down the field.
Jack Bloomer kicks it away.
Good
punt.
Punt.
Fair catch is made inside of the 15 by Jalen Coit. The Wolfpack force the three and out. NC State back on offense on the other side.
Pop-Tarts Bowl is brought to you by Pop-Tarts and Wendy's. Celebrate the return of the holidays with Wendy's Peppermint Frosty.
Under Dave Doran, NC State has won 9 games 4 times. As you get a look at some of the bowl week activities and festivities here in Orlando, Doran now the winningest head coach in program history. 10 is a round number, right? It's one more than 9. It doesn't diminish what he's done in Raleigh. But when we talked to him, he said, no, 10 is a huge deal. It happened once in 2002. Chuck Amato was the head coach.
Yeah.
Phillip Rivers
Chuck
was
Amato
the quarterback.
Had some talent, man. He could recruit him to Raleigh.
Yeah, Jericho Cotchery was on that team. That was a pretty good team.
I just remember he always had legit running backs.
Right.
I mean, some talent.
Yeah, T.A. McClendon was the running back on that 0-2 team.
Yeah.
Dave Doran's put out some next-level talent as well. They want to get to 10 wins. Want to tell everybody this is a 10-win program as you move forward in an era where an expanded playoff is coming. Brennan Armstrong, the team's leading rusher, playing in his final collegiate game, and he picks up 15 for a first down.
That's exactly who he is right there. It's not open. He's not afraid to attack a defender, and he's not going to slide. He's going to engage, which is why I just kind of describe him as a linebacker playing the quarterback position. Nobody's open, not going to force it, and this is one of the best parts of his game is pulling it down and making plays with his legs.
Kansas State wants him to go east-west. Armstrong at his best going north-south.
Exactly right.
Armstrong's got time, low throw, and it skips incomplete.
You look at Brennan Armstrong, and Anish, you mentioned, a lot of quarterbacks will flush out of the pocket, find space. He will put his shoulder down, kind of reminds you stylistically of a Tim Tebow. And I've spoken to him in the past when we covered Virginia and then this year at NC State. I mean, this is one tough kid. He was a safety in high school in the state of Ohio, so he wants to lay the boom, put the shoulder down, and find space inside, like a running back, almost like a fullback.
That's a good comparison. Lefty, about the same size, 6'2", 215.
Kendrick Raphael spun down by Desmond Purnell.
What a tackle by Purnell. Local kid who just makes plays. Grew up in Topeka, Kansas. Hayden High School, and boy, he's something else. Just a sophomore, one of those young players that's going to be around the program for a little while.
K-State, during the regular season, hit hard with injuries at linebacker. Middle linebacker Daniel Green out for the season. They lost Jake Clifton as well. Two big pieces to their defense. They're without their starting nose tackle today, Uso Seumala. Here's the blitz. Armstrong downfield, and it's incomplete. Keenan Garber had strong coverage that time on Dakari Collins, the Clemson transfer, and it's three and out. Well, I should say four and out. They have the first down from Armstrong, and here's Newcaster to punt.
Looked like Collins didn't read the blitz, and everybody, as you're running your route and people are passing by you, we talk about it all the time, you've got to shorten the route up or, you know, go ahead and finish on the fade route, on a nine route.
Seth
Strong was
Porter.
He was fully expecting that, and then all of a sudden the receiver pulls up on it.
Seth Porter waits for the punt. Good kick by Newcaster. Porter muffed it. Live ball, and it's picked up by Kansas State. Flag down, multiple flags down. And now the question is, was that kick catch interference?
No doubt about it, and the flag came immediately.
They might be talking, was the fair catch signal
too
late?
It was a little bit late.
And again, normally you have Phillip Brooks back there, who's got four career punt return touchdowns.
Yeah.
Brooks opted out, and so Porter steps in as the punt return man.
Oh, no doubt. I think the penalty is going to hold up here.
It is a long discussion. Zach Myers was the Wolfpack player who clipped Porter.
There's no foul for kick catch interference.
Oh, wow.
We have an illegal block in the back. Kicking team number 10. That penalty will be enforced from the spot of the foul. First down, media, timeout.
Yeah, so they did think that was a late fair catch signal. 6:21 to go, first quarter. K-State with the ball and the lead. So on the last punt, a Kansas State player pushed an NC State player into the return man.
Right.
That's why there was no flag for kick catch interference. K-State recovers the ball. The penalty, the official said it was on NC State. It's on Kansas State. So it backs up the Wildcats to their own 17-yard line. Giddens gets the call on first down and weaves his way around the left side, dragging tacklers for a nice pickup, 9 on the play.
Boy, he has had big run after big run to start this game. The opening drive of the game, a couple of 10, 12-yard runs. And he is being called on to do a lot today. And you know, quite honestly, this experienced offensive line, why not? Why not run behind him? And Giddens has had an outstanding season. It takes a little bit of pressure off a young quarterback here.
He did get enough for a first down. Moves the sticks. 5 carries, 48 yards for Giddens. Play action. Johnson being pursued by Fordham, and he's got to throw it away. Caden Fordham, 10 in white. He is starting in place of Peyton Wilson. He talked to Luke Kuechly over the summer, and Luke's advice to him was, hey, just run through and smash guys.
Run through their face. And I tell you what, but not fast enough to catch Avery Johnson. You start to see why he's so special and how he garners so much praise from this staff. Fordham, though, he's gotten better as the season's progressed and started to play more and more. Obviously starting today for Wilson.
He's a Florida kid, too. Giddens does not get much. It'll bring up third down.
How does the youngster operate backed up at his own 15? So another test for Avery Johnson. And there's nothing like playing in a ball game. You can talk about, you know, trying to develop a quarterback and having him watch. It's nothing like being on the field in the fire when there's certain situations that arise throughout the game, like being backed up in your own territory, the play calls that come in. How are you going to handle it when you're blitzed on this end of the field?
Earlier in this game, NC State sent an all-out blitz. Avery Johnson read it and hit DJ Giddens for a touchdown pass. This time the Wolfpack drop 8. Johnson over the middle of the field. Low throw. Was it a catch? No. Incomplete. Wanted Keegan Johnson. And here comes Bloomer to punt.
And he had him. Just kind of pulled the string a little bit early on it. Instead of following through or setting his feet once you press up and into the pocket. He'll step forward and then just didn't put quite enough on the football. NC State showing a bunch. They've showed pressure. They've shown zone. I'm trying to confuse the youngster.
Jalen Coit makes the fair catch. 2 more Bowl Mania matchups for you tomorrow afternoon. This should be a good one. Number 22 Clemson squares off against former NC State QB Devin Leary and Kentucky in the Tax Slayer Gator Bowl. Then it's Seth Hennigan in Memphis taking on Rocco Beck and Iowa State in the AutoZone Liberty Bowl. Both games on ESPN, ESPN Deportes, and ESPN Plus.
We'll check that one out right after I coach up a group of basketball players. We'll finish about 1.
How about the season Rocco Beck has had in Ames? Our good buddy Anthony Beck, great tight end in West Virginia with the Jets in the NFL. That's his son.
Playing well.
Got another Iowa State quarterback playing pretty well on Sundays.
Yes, he is.
There's Brennan Armstrong. He'll check down. Low throw. Caught. And that's Raphael, the running back. He's to the 29. NC State in the backfield. Jordan Houston said early in the season,
boy, he
was done. Michael Allen has transferred.
Watch the pressure in Brennan Armstrong's face here. I mean, just that's experience of not flinching, standing in there. Just, hey, I know I might get hit. I may take a shot, but he doesn't care. That's the toughness of Brennan Armstrong when he stands in there, faces the blitz, and still delivers the football on time.
It's when you've been in college for a few years.
Yes, indeed.
Low snap, Raphael works the right side, and he loses a yard. Andre, the other part of NC State's offense that we saw late in the season.
Yeah.
We know Robert and I likes to move fast and throw the ball, and it's a lot of tempo. They backed off of that. They shortened games. They played ball control. They had the ball for 40-plus minutes a couple times late in the season.
Started to play complementary football to their defense, and that gave that allowed the defense later in the year to still be fresh. They love to move the ball around a lot as well. In games this year, they've had as many as 10 players catch passes. And then the second half of the year, the running game really, really improved because of the play of the offensive line. They made some adjustments up front and some changes.
Quarterback draw, Armstrong gets a block, and he picks up a first down.
This is what Kansas State was deathly afraid of. The quarterback runs, in particular, the quarterback draw. And he just knows how to read blocks. He knows how to set them up, and then the toughness to finish at the end of runs. That's Brennan Armstrong. He is back to his old form of 2021 when he had a magical year at Virginia.
Four carries, 50 yards. His last three games did not turn the ball over. Accounted for 9 touchdowns. Here's KC Concepcion, the ACC Rookie of the Year.
How about the block by Brennan Armstrong? It's almost like a counter where Concepcion starts one way. Brennan Armstrong's the guy that the puller. He essentially becomes the puller, throws a nice block on the edge, and that gets Concepcion outside the leverage of the defense. That's a heck of a play by Brennan Armstrong.
Andre, if you're this K-State defense, you have to know where number 10 is lined up on every single play.
You know what that took me back to? All the way back to Dickinson High School. Wing right 21 pitch, and I was one of the lead blockers after the pitch.
And you went to college, played in an offense where you
and threw it almost every down.
Back to Concepcion. It's broken up, incomplete. Marquise Siegel in coverage. That's the matchup to watch.
Yeah, I love the job that our high school coach, Josh Nelson's doing down there right now. He has got a machine rolling and producing college football players all over the country right now. Big shout out to Coach Nelson. I know he's watching today. Loves the college game and just loves football in general.
Delbert Mims, the short yardage back, is in there. Armstrong can do it himself, and he will.
That's hard to stop. When you have a willing runner at that position he's not thinking about being injured. He's not trying to protect himself. He is delivering the punch. He's the aggressor in this fight. You're averaging 7.5 yards per rush so far, NC State.
And it's mostly been the quarterback.
You get everybody spread out like that, it creates better blocking angles for the offensive line. A little bit easier to read for whoever's carrying the ball.
There is Mims, the bulldozer, to the 31-yard line.
That's exactly how the coaching staff described him. He's the team's short yardage back. 5'11", 215. Runs with good body lean, hard to bring him down or get to his legs because of how he's built. It's a good answer in terms of the drive of needing to get back in this game. NC State in a nice drive together here.
Play clock into single digits. Armstrong to throw. Now looks for a running lane. Can't find one.
Yeah, I think he's looking a little bit too soon. Go ahead and read that thing out. See if you can get a receiver to open himself up in zone, but he pulled it down a little bit too fast there.
One quarter in the books in the Pop-Tarts Bowl. Kansas State 7-0 this year when leading after 15 minutes.
Wolfpack quarterback Brennan Armstrong in the draw game.
Well, we've got to do a great job of hanging in there a little bit with our linebackers and safeties. Then we got to stun a little bit up front. He's a terrific player. You get a fifth-year senior playing in a bowl game, that's always a challenge.
Thank you, Coach.
You bet.
Chris Kleiman, already in his fifth season at Kansas State, hired by athletic director Gene Taylor. There were some at the time that questioned it. It has been nothing short of a grand slam.
It's been fantastic. You got a proven winner, and it's all he's done since he arrived on campus.
It's all he did in Fargo. Brennan Armstrong looking to run here on third down, and watch him zigzag to the 20-yard line for a first.
That's Justin James, how that shoulder pad that he received tastes. Wow. I mean, he just knocked him backwards. That shows you the toughness of Brennan Armstrong. You're going to see number five. He kind of shows up late. He just had a mouthful of shoulder pad of Brennan Armstrong and bounced right off of it. Amazing run.
The last few games of the year, he just looks like his old self.
He does. He's playing with a lot of confidence right now.
Why not? Quarterback run again. And Armstrong torpedoes inside the 15.
You're playing in your last college game, and he is just letting it all hang out. Showing the toughness, showing exactly what made him a name and at Virginia, and then transferred to NC State. Finally got it together the latter part of the year when he was reinserted into the lineup.
We had NC State on a Friday night against Louisville. He didn't play well, and that's putting it politely.
Exactly.
Benched right after the game. MJ Morris takes over. Then Morris says, hey, I'm only playing four games. I'm going to redshirt. Morris now at Maryland is Concepcion. Pinballs off a couple of Wildcats, and it sets up third and short. And when Morris decided he was done playing this year because of the redshirt rule, Armstrong came back in. And what Dave Dorn said is the moment that Armstrong, as a transfer, won this game.
Is that where we are right now in college football?
That's where we are.
A guy gets, they give you the starting job, but you tell them, hey, I still want a redshirt because I'm going to transfer. That's amazing to me. I mean, that goes against every principle that I believe in terms of competition and competing.
On third down, it's Armstrong. He's going to be close, but a little shy.
Something's got to be done. This has got to be fixed. I mean, the NCAA, to put it lightly, they messed this up. And college football is still a great game, but there's some tinkering that obviously needs to go on.
It's become a free-for-all, especially this time of the year. Poachers, agents.
You can start with where the transfer portal opens, and that should be after the bowl season.
Armstrong comes under center. On fourth and less than a yard, it's a quarterback sneak.
That's going to be close.
This will depend on the spot. Kansas State saying they've got it. Delbert Mims pointing the other way for NC State.
I didn't get that short. It's played by the freshman Austin Romaine in there. They get lower than the NC State offensive line. It's Kansas State football.
Tarts have been putting smiles on people's faces for almost 60 years. You can eat them right out of the wrapper, but if you want them to hit different like me, put them in the toaster oven. Kansas State quarterback Avery Johnson told me he loves Pop-Tarts. As a kid, he was all about strawberry and brown sugar cinnamon. Now he's a s'mores guy like me. I've consumed thousands in my life, and it's mind-boggling, Andre. We will witness history tonight. The guy next to you's never tried one. How pathetic is that?
Pathetic. It's bad.
Well, it's time to change that then.
It's bad.
It's time to change it.
Come on, man.
So I got brown sugar cinnamon here. Do you want to try one?
I'm going to watch you try one. I had some for breakfast yesterday.
Just realize I was the guy that dunked a cream-filled cookie in mayonnaise and ate it. So this is not scary.
And they're good. They're delicious.
It's delicious.
Delicious. But you got to go. You got to have some plain with a little butter on it, some boiled eggs, and bacon. That's the breakfast of champions right there.
Flavors. The limited edition ones too, guys. You know, when I was a kid, there was like a Jolly Rancher flavor, A&W root beer. When it comes to sugar, my mom wrote the book, man. I was all Pop-Tarts, Captain Crunch. We were flying off the walls, putting
holes and dents in cars. We're Sugar Rush Central.
We had all the bad cereal growing up for whatever reason. Maybe there weren't enough coupons out there. Huh? I don't know. Pop-Tarts never made it into our household.
I can't remember a time that
I feel deprived as a child now.
You finally joined the Pop-Tart gang, huh?
What a look at Avery Johnson. The ability to improv. But he's taken down in the backfield. That's a nice play by Shaheen Battle, one of the cornerbacks.
So fast, so talented. What I like about this young man the most is his eyes are always down the field looking to deliver the football.
So, Kark, as the story goes in this game, the winning team will eat the edible mascot. What flavor is the edible mascot? Have you found out?
I have, but that is classified information. I cannot disclose.
Okay, so that'll be embargoed, I'm assuming,
yeah,
until later in the game.
You just keep Pop-Tarts. You got like 1,000 left to go to catch us.
I do. I'm way behind. I'm halfway through one. Jace Brown, the freshman, makes the catch. As Andre said, he really emerged as a big play threat late in the season.
In the second half of the year, he has been pretty much in the lineup, and you're talking two true freshmen that are going to play a lot of football together, working in the offseason together, in the summers throwing passes. The chemistry between the two already you're starting to see it.
Giddens goes wide. Another screen pass, and it's dropped by Garrett Oakley, and again.
And that was going to go for a minute. That was going for a while if he hangs on to that one. He's got a bunch of big fellas, bunch of big grunts out in front of him.
If all was well, that would have gone to Ben Sinnott.
Yes, yes.
The all-everything tight end for Kansas State who's opted out to get ready for the draft.
And I think he is going to be a high pick because he's so versatile. He can do a lot of stuff. Can play fullback, tight end, H-back, wide receiver, whatever you need Sinnott to do. He's going to be a heck of a player for a lot of people.
How about this? Fake punt, Kansas State. Into Wolfpack territory for a gain of 30. It's Jack Bloomer.
And you got big Cooper Beebe leading the way, the big Mack truck that's disguised as a left guard. You get behind that big guy, you got to feel pretty good. I mean, the big guy looking up somebody to block. And this is just a walk in the park for Jack Bloomer. Nobody around the punter on the fake punt.
I guess the right key out of the toaster
that Beebe was still on the field.
It's a gain of 30 by the punter. Now Johnson hands it off to Giddens. Turbines away. And he's got close to another first down, a gain of 8.5.
He's not a blazer, but he is a good, solid running back that I think is going to play for a long, long time, even after his days at Kansas State, because he has so much. The vision is so good. His ability to break tackles is equally as good.
Double tight end set here, high snap. Johnson off play action, a strike down the seam. Oakley redeems himself.
Went right back to him.
And it sets up a first and goal.
Love it. Love how a guy puts one on the ground. Hey, I trust you. I know what you can do. I'm going to come right back to you. And nice seam ball right in the hands of Garrett Oakley. Starting to heat up is Avery Johnson.
I'm told Pop-Tarts are always better when heated.
I want to go into my Avery Johnson. The way the Avery Johnson speaks, being from Louisiana.
Here's the give to Giddens.
A push to get him in.
Did he get there? No signal yet. And now, touchdown, Kansas State. Second TD of the game for Giddens. One through the air, now one on the ground.
And it was all made possible by the fake punt of Jack Bloomer being led by Cooper Beebe. But then you go to your workhorse, and Giddens And then the big fellas get behind him. They start to push. KT Leviston helping him out along with Cooper Beebe. Kansas State, an extra point away from being up 14.
Going into the season, a big question for Kansas State: how do you replace Deuce Vaughn? DJ Giddens answered that early on.
Two totally different types of players, but he fits what Coach Kleiman wants to do offensively.
You get this Wildcat team in the red zone, goal to go, one of the best in the nation. Chris Tennant with the PAT, and Kansas State with a two-score lead. It started with some shenanigans.
Yeah, the fake punt, but Jack Blummer leading the way by the big fella, Cooper Beebe, and then it's Giddens getting him in the end zone, giving Kansas State a 14-0 lead.
Is brought to you by Pop-Tarts.
You just saw the edible mascot. He came out of a toaster, a giant toaster, minutes before kickoff.
Can you really put the frosted ones in a toaster, though?
Well, here's the sad part of the story. After the game, he will be devoured, he will die, and he will be his own last meal.
Amazing.
Let's take a look at the Bowl Challenge Cup standings, brought to you by Progressive. No real transition off of that mascot.
No. SEC still have eight games to go, though. Big 12 off to a nice start, and then the ACC are even. They had a lot of teams. What was it, 11 teams make bowl games this year? That's awesome.
Been a banner season for the ACC in a lot of ways. Obviously, you know, there is still the Florida State chatter. Julian Gray reverses field and somehow gets across the 20-yard line. Looked like it might have been a busted play. Colby McAllister, the special teams tackle. 7:20 to go in this opening half here in Orlando. Wildcats leading 14-0. Welcome back to the Pop-Tarts Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Mania. Anish Raff, Andre Ware starting to feel that sugar rush. There's two in a pack. Are you supposed to eat both of them?
Oh, yeah. And sometimes you'll split, and when I'm really hungry, I'll go for a third. And then I got one left over. I got to put it in a Ziploc and save it for the next day. But, oh, yeah, I'm definitely going through two of them.
So if you open one, non-perishable.
Yeah, you just put it in a Ziploc, save it for the next day. It's good.
Empty set here.
Delicious, man.
Brennan Armstrong's been the offense for the Wolfpack. And he gets to the outside. He's up to north of 80 yards rushing.
Pop-Tart roll. You never save one for the next day, Andre. You eat what you open, right? Like, if there's two in there, there's no tomorrow, man.
Yeah, but if you're still hungry, you go for one more, and it might be enough, so you got to save it.
Don't either open for it later or the next down day. For two, man. That's it. Case closed. You've got a sweet tooth, man. I've eaten with you for a while.
Oh, you know that, man. You know
Pop-Tarts it. Pop-Tarts are right up your alley.
Another quarterback run. Boy, Brennan Armstrong, he might get 100 yards on the ground just in this first half.
What a nice kick out block by DeMarcus Jones the second. And I just think it's going to take more than the legs and the toughness of Brennan Armstrong to get NC State back in this game. It's going to take Concepcion getting him involved. It's going to take Julian Gray getting him involved. Have more skill position players, and Raphael, the running back. More of a complete offense than just Brennan Armstrong, because eventually K-State's going to shut that down.
They got two tight ends in the game. Mims, the power back, with a first down.
I'll throw Delbert Mims in there as well, with being the team's short yardage back. He is tough as they come. Right in the mold of Armstrong. But I think they're going to have to do something through the air in order to get back in this football game, or it's going to get tough.
only 9 yards passing. NC State with 105 on the ground, 86 of those coming from Armstrong. Now Concepcion, who's in there to take the snap, he's done that a lot down the stretch. He goes into the slot, Armstrong at quarterback, little RPO, juggled, caught by Penix, who tight ropes the sideline and gets out of bounds for a first down near midfield.
Well, nice job, because you're thinking Concepcion, so it's good eye candy to move to him. You're thinking the ball's going that direction. They go totally opposite, and it leaves Penix wide open out in the flat. Now, if he doesn't, you know, just bobble it and step out of bounds, he may still be making a call.
On the slant, the ball is batted down, incomplete.
I'll tell you what, it's probably a good thing, because Colby McAllister was right in line to pick it off. And if it gets through to McAllister, it is bye-bye, baby. Hey, he is right there. He's able to come down with that thing. Forget about it. Nobody's going to catch it.
The only guy that probably would have had a chance would have been the QB.
He's tough, but I don't know about fleet of foot.
On second down, Armstrong back to the air. Pressure off the edge. Downfield, almost intercepted by Siegel.
And they told us how good Siegel actually is. Love him on the back end so much that Coach Klannerman told us he's gonna be wherever Casey Concepcion is, that's the side he's gonna go to. And so he leaves him for the inside safety, and he's gonna take the slot receiver. So good on the back end. Both he and VJ Payne.
K-State rushes four. Armstrong checks it down, and NC State able to pick up the first down. It's Raphael, man, with the yards after the catch.
What a collision. Justin James and Raphael. James came flying up, and there's no give. I mean, he didn't push on the brakes at all. Tried to run right through the running back. My goodness, a physical game. Whew.
Look painful.
Makes me bite that. You got to bite down on your mouthpiece a little bit on that one after seeing that.
Concepcion joins Mims in the backfield. The handoff is to Concepcion. Gets to the outside and run out of bounds at the 31-yard line. A pickup of 8 on the play. Again, they've been hit hard with attrition to their running back, so they said, hey, let's just use Concepcion as another running back. The idea late in the season, get the ball in the hands of your best player.
Yeah, he's not going to run between the tackles, but he is a playmaker that can make plays out on the edges, as he did there. That's a heck of an 8-9 yard run for NC State. So it puts you in second and short. Now you got the entire playbook. You can take a shot right here.
Low snap. Armstrong keeps it. Big hole up the middle. Brennan Armstrong.
Wow.
Touchdown, Wolfpack.
Maybe he is a little more fleet of foot than we give him credit for. What a run by Brennan Armstrong. Getting his team right back in this thing. This was a designed quarterback run. The offensive line, they do one heck of a job. They get a player to overrun and a linebacker to overrun it, and Brennan Armstrong trotting into the end zone untouched. We got ourselves a ball game.
The PAT is good. 13 carries, 129 yards on the ground for Brennan Armstrong. 31 on that play to pay dirt.
Yes.
I can't wait.
I can't wait to see that.
How about what Barry and Mullen did last night in Charlotte? The Mayo sickos. K-State will bring it out to the 25. Tomorrow night, 8 Eastern, it's the 88th annual Goodyear Cotton Bowl Classic on ESPN. Missouri and Ohio State will go at it. Missouri number 9, they beat Kansas State on a 60-plus yard field goal earlier this year. Ohio State ranked 7th in the final college football playoff rankings. 3:22 to go in the first half of this one. Both teams have all three timeouts. And so far, what do you make of the ballyhooed freshman Avery Johnson?
I like what he's done so far, and he's kind of really kind of playing a calm game. It's not too big. The moment's not too big for him. That's for sure.
Finds Oakley as tight end in the flat. Oakley and Swanson will have to step up today with no Ben Sinnott.
A lot of mental and physical growth for Avery Johnson this year. Came to camp 6'2", 170. Now he's at 188 and bulking up and putting some muscle on. He'll lean on these offensive linemen, all five starters back from a year ago. None of them opted out, including Cooper Beebe, who's the number one rated guard in Mel Kiper's draft.
Number 50 up front.
Saw him leading that fake punt. Oh, what a nice run by Giddens. Kind of ducked under everybody and right behind Big Cooper Beebe, right on cue, Kark.
I love how Beebe's playing in this game too, right, Andre? I mean, he's got a huge future. Could play in the NFL for over a decade, but it's the commitment. Yeah, exactly. And that's what Coach Kleiman said. Wanted to finish this out with the group he came in with, and he's got a younger brother on the team too, leading by example.
Giddens on the cutback.
I think more people should take the approach of Cooper Beebe. College football would be a lot better place than all this. And you know, I don't blame just the kids. I blame parents. I blame relatives. People looking out for themselves. I mean, take the approach of Cooper Beebe and gut it out and do what you're supposed to do when you make the commitment to a university.
As Clark said, he wanted to see it through. Two-time All-American. Two-time Big 12 Offensive Lineman of the Year.
He's as good as it gets.
Nice play there in the secondary. Sean Brown swats it away. Third down.
Nice play on the back end by Brown. Really a good young player, just a redshirt sophomore, but excellent ball skills on the back end. Now, when they get in your zone area, essentially, Anish, it becomes man-to-man. You got to break on the football, and the reactionary time of Sean Brown was right on point.
Let's see what Tony Gibson dials up on third down for NC State.
Play clock down to about 5.
Down to 2. And now play clock about to expire. Chris Kleiman calls a timeout.
That's probably the only thing that has surprised Avery Johnson in this one.
And you got to remember, Kansas State's offensive coordinator, Colin Klein, left for Texas A&M. So you've got Connor Riley, the offensive line coach. He's calling the plays today. Now, he's familiar with Chris Kleiman. Those two worked together going back to their days at North Dakota State. Yeah. Two more bowl games for you on Saturday. That's on ESPN. Jackson Dart leading number 11 Ole Miss. Their top 20 offense against Penn State. Nittany Lions had the best defense in college football. And then a few subplots in that second game. Georgia and Florida State. That's at 4 Eastern. That's the Orange Bowl.
And you get Rodemaker transfer. Give me a break. Come on, guys.
Yeah, take
Rodemaker. What are you doing?
Number 2 quarterback at Florida State, who took over when Jordan Travis went down. How about the run by Johnson? Here's the wheels. And he takes the big hit by Fitzgerald, absorbs it, picks up a dozen, and a K-State first down.
You see the speed of Avery Johnson. You better have the proper angle, and you better be locking on when he pulls it down.
And with the Wildcats looking to go tempo, Dave Dorn calls a timeout. We'll be back in 10 seconds after a message from Ally.
Saving for your next big game tailgate? Tackle your savings goals with Ally, a bank that's your ally. Back to you.
Now, one of the interesting subplots in this game is that both teams are familiar with this defense. In fact, the K-State defensive coaches had gone to Raleigh to study Tony Gibson's 3-3-5-D.
Yeah, and so, you know, both quarterbacks are kind of facing what they were going to see in the bowl game each and every week, because that's their base defense. So Avery Johnson has seen all year long what NC State does, and so has Brennan Armstrong.
Three-man rush. Johnson on the drag, hits Brown, groundhogs away from a defender, and turns it into a first down. The true freshman, dynamic in space.
He's 5'11", 175. He's going to put on a few pounds this offseason, get faster, stronger.
Under 2 minutes, clock stops on a first down, sideline throw, Brown out of bounds, and that'll stop the clock again.
What a nice job, the entire operation of Avery Johnson to Jace Brown. I mean, and how they're managing the clock, getting smart, young players, just true freshmen, getting out of bounds at the proper time, not trying to do too much and wasting time to have to force a timeout. This is impressive. And that's just coaching.
The handoff goes to Giddens, big crease left side. And he slips down across the 20. It'll momentarily stop the clock. 11 more for Giddens, who's at 90 yards rushing in this first half.
And he averaged about 5.5 yards per carry this year. He got close to just under 1,100 yards and 9 touchdowns. Boy, what a year he's having.
Johnson to the air. He's flushed out. And wisely throws it away. When you watch him, there's nothing about him that screams freshman. He looks so in control.
Yeah, there's no nerves. Yeah, he just loves the game, and you can see it. It just kind of oozes out of his pores. He's played a lot of football and had a tremendous amount of success. And it's starting to carry over here at Kansas State. This is kind of his launching pad for 2024. And look out, Big 12, because Avery Johnson's going to be something special.
This game they view as a springboard for next season, when this young man could become a household name in college football if all goes well.
Well, we're going to be talking about him for the next few years, certainly.
Johnson steps up, has room to run. Fakes the throw, watch the moves, touchdown, Avery Johnson.
My, what a special player we are watching. Yeah, that'll run you out of town right there. That'll make you transfer. I mean, feels the blitz, or feels the pressure, steps up. Nothing's there, and then that nice cut right there. That's what gets him into the end zone, some toughness at the end of it. Yeah, I can see why.
The extra point by Tennant is good.
Can't hold that on for long, you know it?
You can't keep that under wraps.
You can't keep that under wraps. That's special, and yeah, I can see why guys are skating out of town.
We've passed Christmas. The presents are all open. And this season, for every field goal and extra point made by participating universities, Allstate will make a contribution to the university's general scholarship fund. Thank you, Allstate. And for those who are watching Kansas State for the first time, perhaps, Johnson's played in 7 games prior to today, mostly used as a runner. He has not thrown the ball until today more than 10 times in a game. Will Howard, who had waited his turn at Kansas State, had been the guy going into the season. He played well down the stretch last year for a team that won the Big 12 championship a season ago.
And had a ton of experience coming back, and this young man just kept pressing, kept getting better. But by, you know, the second half of the season, they were essentially splitting time. And it was just, the writing was on the wall. And now we know why.
You're watching the Pop-Tarts Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Mania.
By the kicking team.
Minutes before kickoff, we had an edible mascot emerge from a giant toaster at midfield. The winning team today will devour said edible mascot.
I don't know that I would want to be a part of that, but I'd like to take my Pop-Tarts out of the wrapper and devour them that way.
Well, we're still waiting to find out how that's going to look.
Running around, and it may be some huge Pop-Tart that they've created.
I'm just curious, how does that work? Do we break off pieces, hand them to the players, or do we descend on the mascot like lions attacking a zebra?
This will be entertaining.
Second option makes for better television. Brennan Armstrong chased, and he misses the check down Raphael, second down.
And Raphael had Siegel right in his vicinity.
Armstrong 1 yard shy of a career high in rushing. And Giddens, not only the 90 yards on the ground, he had a 37-yard touchdown catch as well.
He is really put on a show, both guys here in the first half. We got Concepcion limping off the field. That is a huge part of the offense for NC State.
NC State lost some depth to the transfer portal and wide receiver, but Concepcion really made a name for himself early this year. He kept on showing up, kept on showing up. They thought they had something special in him when they saw him in camp. And then just the variety of ways he can impact the game. That's a big loss. Receiver, yeah. Running back, more than 1,000 yards of total offense this year.
He's a huge part of their game plan from week to week, and certainly a big part of it today, as you would describe, a lot of guys sitting out this one, choosing not to play, and they were going to rely on him heavily.
Parrish pulled him down, and Concepcion came off limping, and that one thrown away. There's a flag on the play.
Maybe on Parrish holding down the field. Pass interference on Parrish.
Pass interference, defense number 10. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
And this one's on Jacob Parrish, who's in over the slot. And just kind of held on a little bit too long. He's a former wrestler, so he's not afraid to put his hands on you.
It gives the Pack the ball at midfield. They've got two timeouts. Concepcion back in there. K-State brings the blitz. Flag thrown.
Yeah, false start. A couple of receivers left early. Maybe a lineman as well picked up.
False start. Offense, number 86. 5-yard penalty. First down.
That's Dakari Collins. And all the penalties were an area where NC State really cleaned it up late in the season. You look at some of their losses early, just sloppy turnovers, penalties. Only 23 penalties in the previous five games. Three-man rush. Armstrong stands in the pocket. He's got Raphael. And he's able to get across the 40. That's a first down. It'll momentarily stop the clock. And now we get a timeout from Dave Doran. One left for NC State.
Nice job there. Deep zone drops. It just tells you as a quarterback. To check it down. And a lot of young quarterbacks are throwing into coverage. When that will get you the first down, will stop the clock, as you mentioned momentarily, for the chains to move. Dave Doran elected to go ahead and take the timeout, save a few seconds there that might allow him an extra play or two.
They've got a kicker with a strong leg.
Yeah.
Braden Narveson earlier this year against Duke set a school record with a 57-yard field goal.
That's crazy. 57.
Concepcion is the slot receiver to the top of your screen.
Good
nearest
to see him back.
to the left tackle. They keep it on the ground here with Raphael. They've got that one timeout. He brings it inside the 35. Clock continues to run. 30 seconds and ticking.
Don't know if I would have made that choice with a timeout. You got to go ahead and take it, but interesting.
To the air. Sideline throw. Catch made. Collins out of bounds. Clock stops with 17 seconds.
And the reason why, you burn the timeout to stop it, then you run the football, almost scream stop it again. But the prior play had you with a first down and momentarily stopping the clock, which you could have called another play at the line of scrimmage. So I don't really understand that that sequence by NC State.
Now with the one timeout, you got to imagine quarterback run is still on the table here if there's something for Armstrong. Here's the blitz. Armstrong throws. Concepcion reaches up, makes the catch. He's out of bounds with 13 seconds.
This quick decision, and I'm shocked that Kansas State's giving up the sidelines here to NC State where they can stop the clock.
Do you think of one shot to the end zone here?
Well, you can run anything with that one timeout. It's just got to be a little quicker than normal.
Armstrong down the middle. Concepcion holding on.
Now you call the timeout.
And they do get the timeout. Well, you're going to get the momentary stoppage, and now it looks like they will call the timeout.
Timeout, North Carolina State. So third and final charge timeout will be 30 seconds in length.
Concepcion shaking up after the play.
He took a big shot over the middle, and this is not a lot of guys are willing to sign up for this. You going across the middle, you know you're going to take a shot. And it was delivered by V.J. Payne, the other safety playing opposite Siegel. Siegel's in coverage on Concepcion. We've told you about that matchup all game long. And then Payne comes in from the other side.
And he's Schroff, Andre Ware, Paul Carcaterra. So no timeouts. Ball on the 8-yard line. 8 seconds to go in the half. The offense is coming out. You've got one play here, but it's got to be touchdown, incomplete, or you got to get out of bounds to stop the clock.
It's quick. It's to the end zone. If it's complete, obviously a touchdown, but if it's not, you still have time for it on an incompletion to get your field goal unit on and knock one through.
Concepcion back in there, slot right.
It looks like they're going to blitz here.
Now they back off. Dropping eight. Armstrong rolling out, throws off the hands of Keon Lassane. 4 seconds remain. And here's the kick team.
That should have been six. Excellent throw by Brennan Armstrong. You gotta deliver. It's a pressure situation. You gotta be a big time player in that situation. Ball's thrown exactly where it needed to be, to the outside. And an opportunity missed here by NC State to get in the end zone.
Narveson's been reliable. This from 26. And he makes the kick. Triple zeros on the clock. That sends us to halftime. Kansas State with a 21-10 lead against NC State. Wildcats looking to get to 9 wins. The Wolfpack trying to get to 10 wins for the second time in program history. Off now to Bristol. Matt Barry, Roddy Jones, and Sam Acho with you.
You're watching Capital One Bowl Mania.
Welcome back to the Pop-Tarts Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Mania. Right now it's Kansas State, one half away from devouring the edible Pop-Tarts mascot. Anish Schroff, Andre Ware, Paul Carcaterra is down to the sideline. The formula in the first half, right out of the toaster.
That's right,
run the football.
It's that way for Kansas State. Giddens had a heck of a first half. And for NC State, Brennan Armstrong was the answer for NC State.
Now both teams ran for 150 yards in the first half. Armstrong went for over 100 for NC State. Giddens for K-State finished with 90 yards in the opening half. The Wolfpack will receive this third quarter kickoff. NC State looking to win 10 games in a season. It's only been done once before in the school's 137-year history. That was in 2002. Chuck Amato was the head coach, and Philip Rivers was the quarterback.
They stole a possession at the end of the first half, turned it into a field goal. Would have loved to have put it in the end zone, but they did kick a field goal, getting the ball first here to start the second half. See if they can draw even closer to Kansas State.
Julian Gray, a dangerous return man, but he signals for a fair catch. And we look at today's clutch delivery brought to you by Chipotle.
Now let's take a look at DJ Giddens for Kansas State. Started with big run after big run, leading him on a touchdown possession. And then he's showing his skills as a receiver. The young quarterback Avery Johnson delivering through the air, but then Giddens showing some toughness between the tackles to get in the end zone. 90 yards rushing, 37 receiving. He's been everything and in the end zone twice for the Wildcats.
On first down, Brennan Armstrong gives to Concepcion on the end around. He'll look to throw, and he underthrows Collins, who was open. Clark?
Yeah, and Brennan Armstrong's been the bright spot for the Wolfpacks. 117 yards on the ground. He's been physical, he's been strong, and he's been their only offense. And Dave Doran told me they need explosive plays in this half. Don't be surprised if you see a big shot from Armstrong early in the third quarter. Defensively, the biggest problem is tackling, taking down Avery Johnson, the superb true freshman quarterback. But who can take a guy down like that, Andre?
Clark, with numbers, you're not tackling much in practice during bowl prep. And so you're going to see a lot of that during bowl games this year.
Blitz coming, shot play, Collins the catch.
And good call, Paul Calcaterra, with his report. Right on cue, NC State goes up top, and they're able to find Mr. Collins. Nice job as well by the offensive line, giving Armstrong some time, and he just drops that one right in the bucket. What a throw. Heck of a throw on a corner route.
Collins had only a dozen catches all season. Did have an impact in the regular season finale when NC State knocked off UNC.
Well, that's just a shot in the arm this offense needs. Sometimes you just got to prove that you can do it.
Blitz again. It's a run. It's Raphael. And he picks up about three on the play. Kansas State defensively today, they are without their starting nose tackle, Uso Seomalo. So Damian Ilalio, number 56, got the start initially on the defensive line. They've been rotating. You've seen Javon Banks, who's in there now. Wildcats defensively. Last seven games, they came into this game with 18 takeaways, which was tops in the country.
And Banks in the middle, he's a little lighter than the other two guys. Only 290 pounds, where the other two are up over three plus. And so it's just a little easier to move him inside.
Second and seven, Armstrong stands in the pocket, throws into coverage, and it's incomplete, out of bounds. Wanted Lassane, and there was no window.
None whatsoever. Keenan Garber looked like so he was trying to tip that back in bounds so someone else could come up with it. Had some good team defense there. It hit over the top, but now clamping down a little bit in coverage with some safety help over the top.
Garber's become a pretty good corner. Last year he moved from receiver to cornerback for the Big 12 championship game against TCU.
Big play here on third down. Get close to it. I imagine Coach Doran's going to go for it on fourth down.
K-State looks to be in man. Armstrong will throw. It's hauled in. Concepcion, but he is shy of the marker. Fourth down. And here comes the kick team.
Just right back around the original line of scrimmage with that reception. So you don't gain much. If it gets to fourth and short, I imagine he would have rolled the dice and gone for it on fourth down. But you got a pretty good kicker here, well within his range.
a 49-yarder for Braden Narbison. Center cut.
It's like breaking a Pop-Tart right down the middle, baby.
Except you get three. The Pop-Tart bag, you only get two. Welcome back to the Pop-Tarts Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Mania. Paul Carcaterra down on the field with the consensus National Defensive Player of the Year.
That's right, the Bednarik Award winner, the Buckus Award winner for the National Linebacker of the Year, Peyton Wilson. And Peyton, this team this year did some pretty special things. 9 wins if you get 10 here tonight. Only the second time in 137 years of Wolfpack football. What was it about this team that made them special?
Yeah, I think it's just the love we had for one another. I think that Coach Dorn, you know, Coach Gibson, Coach and I, you know, all the guys that are in the front office just do a great job of creating a culture here. And at the end of the day, it doesn't matter who's playing. We're going to go out there for 60 minutes, and we're going to try to fight, and we're going to try to claw it to the last second.
I know you're preparing for the NFL draft and getting ready. Why was it important for you to be here with your team on the sidelines tonight?
Yeah, I mean, we talk about finish here at NC State. I mean, I love these guys with everything. I mean, they're going to be my brothers for life. Not being here would have been a lot worse than, you know, being here, just, you know, being able to support them and see the young guys like Caden Fordham, Devon Betty, you know, KB step up and play football. It's awesome to see.
When I watch you play, I think of your motor. I think of how relentless you are. That comes from somewhere. Where was it?
You have to credit our strength and conditioning staff, just how hard they push us, how hard they make us work. You know, also credit to my parents, you know, letting me play 3 sports growing up, just, you know, continuing to just work on my conditioning and push me to be my best self.
I know Andre up in the booth loves a 3-sport athlete. You played some lacrosse, you played football, you played some hoops?
Nah, I wrestled in high school.
Wrestling, that's one tough guy. Got to ask you before we bounce, favorite Pop-Tart growing up?
They will get mad at me, but Wildberry.
Wildberry? No, you're a standard guy. Andre loves that. Best of luck. You're going to have a long career in the NFL, and you've been a pleasure to watch, bud.
Thanks so much.
The best thing he said was being allowed to play 3 sports. That's a lost art. Everybody wants to specialize in one. Let them play all. Every sport helps with the others.
I thought you were going to say Wildberry.
More well-rounded athlete by doing that. Don't box kids in to one sport at a young age.
Third down for K-State. We've had the pleasure of covering Peyton Wilson over the years, and
Carr
caught up the motor nonstop. And this kid has fought through multiple injuries. Go back a few years ago, he was the ACC's leading tackler, then had a couple of injury-ravaged seasons, bounced back this year, won pretty much every major award. The city of Raleigh held a day for him. That's what he meant. Avery Johnson might get that in Manhattan one day. We are watching the makings of not just a star, but perhaps a superstar.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. I mean, we are getting an audition into the future at Kansas State, and it looks bright at the quarterback spot. This is a guy that we will talk about in the conversation of, dare I say it, one of the best players in college football in the very near future.
There's Giddens, who's gobbled for a loss. Clark.
You know, I asked Coach Klieman at halftime what excited him the most about Avery Johnson getting his first start. He said his competitiveness, how calm he is, but also he said he's the fastest guy on the field, so he's hard to take down. And talk about 3-sport athletes, Andre. I spoke to Avery this week, basketball player, baseball player. He talked about being a middle infielder and some of the arm releases, how that's helped him as a quarterback.
You can see it.
Johnson trying to avoid the rush. He's able to. And floats it out of bounds. You saw how upset Davin Van, who's played a lot of football at NC State, was. He was in the backfield.
I got
thought
him.
He had the freshman dead to rights. And you saw him pound the ground with his fist.
Twice. I got him twice. And then, no, I don't. He's out and looking down the field. And he's got some stuff that you get just can't teach. Because most young quarterbacks would have taken off with that, taken a shot. Maybe the ball comes loose or force it into coverage, throws it away, come back on third down.
Let's see if NC State gets exotic here on third down and long. They bring the blitz. It's a give to Giddens. And he's forced down by Van.
Uses to go
up
down.
Six.
Wow.
Still moving the chains. Wow, he got all the way close to midfield. Looked like he was going to be down at least 3 yards earlier. Well, now it's fourth down and two.
He puts him in a position where it's decision time for Coach Kleiner. And I think he's going to trot his punter out, but man, what an effort by Giddens.
Defensive injury.
Boy, this young man is something else. And Davin Van, I think, is the injured player down.
NC State will attend to the injured player. We'll step aside. Welcome back to the Pop-Tarts Bowl, all a part of Capital One Bowl Mania. Kansas State with an 8-point lead, almost 5 minutes gone by in the third quarter. Davin Van, one of the D-ends for NC State, injured on the last play before we went to break, trying to tackle DJ Giddens.
It's just tough to bring him down, and you get a lot of guys around you, your legs and everything's getting tangled up in there. Hopefully he's okay, and love to see him come back into this game. We're going to need him here in the second half.
Bloomer on to punt it away. He had a 30-yard run on a fake punt earlier.
I wanted to see if BB is indeed on the punt team, because he was on the fake a minute ago. He's there. He's one of the personal protectors stepping in the middle.
Good punt here. High kick. Coit with the fair catch at the 22. Coming up next here on ESPN, we cap off this bowl four-pack with a couple of ranked teams. Top 15 matchup in the Valero Alamo Bowl, Arizona and Oklahoma. This will be Oklahoma's final game as a member of the Big 12 Conference. They in Texas off to the SEC next year. And you watch a team like Kansas State, Andre, with a young quarterback in Avery Johnson.
Yeah.
In a league that will have a power vacuum with Oklahoma and Texas gone. Boy, you can dream in the Little Apple.
Yes, you can. Yeah, you got the right ingredients at that position.
Ball's on the ground. And NC State covers it up.
I mean, I'm looking at that last punt. How many guards around the country, and who would be daring enough to put their starting left guard on the punt team as a personal protector? It tells me a lot about the trust in Cooper Beebe, the kind of athlete that Cooper Beebe is. And he's leading the way on the fake punt, so it makes you think every time, hey, the possibility of the fake is there, and you got to have somebody there to account for it.
On second and long, Armstrong moves the pocket. And he will escape out of bounds. No gain, third and long.
This is where Kansas State has got to get off the field, and Brennan Armstrong and his experience going to kind of take what's there. Gotten in a bad situation with the bad snap on first down. You're behind the down and distance marker. This is the last place that you want to take a chance on the field and turn it over.
KC Concepcion, who's been their top playmaker, is lined up in the slot, top of your screen. Julian Gray motions that way. K-State brings the blitz. Armstrong backpedaling, loads up, downfield. Concepcion adjusting and makes the catch over Parrish.
Parrish never found the football. When Concepcion looks back, Parrish should look back immediately. He never does, and that's what gives Concepcion the line of sight to the football. Excellent job in terms of putting the ball up, just letting him adjust to it. Great job of concentration. That's huge for NC State.
Now we talk about what Avery Johnson is to Kansas State. KC Concepcion as a freshman, that same kind of upside
impressive.
You can dream on in Raleigh. Armstrong again going to go long. He wants Collins. Incomplete, off target.
They hit that earlier with Dakari Collins on a corner route over Keenan Garber. But this time it's Siegel. He's a little bit better in coverage on the back end.
A And you're starting to see K-State defensively, they're framing their coverage to keep Armstrong in the pocket.
There's no doubt about it. They're not going to let him run, force him to throw the ball from the pocket. And let's see if you can beat us that way. But they know he can beat them with his legs if they allow him outside.
Raphael tunnels ahead. It brings up third down and five.
That's a nice, tough run inside. By McKay, Dylan McMahon, who is one of the top-rated centers across the country. Solid run blocker, and he shows it there. Just kind of improves every single time he's out.
He squats 570, Andre. Bench is almost 400, and power cleans about 400. Armstrong on the move, pursued, gets away near the sideline, and it's incomplete. Fourth down pressure from Brendan Mott.
And Mott's kind of kicking himself because he had him dead to rights and could not get Brendan Armstrong on the ground. He's going to bring up fourth down here. And looks like they trotted Narveson back on the field again for about a 52-yarder.
As we said, he has hit from as far as 57 this year. For his career, 4 for 11 from 50-plus. One is going to be no good. Pulled it.
And give Kansas State some pretty good field position to start their drive.
6:46 to go, quarter number three. K-State by 8. Welcome back to the Pop-Tarts Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Mania. That is Ripken, the tea retrieving dog. We put a GoPro on him. And I mean, the mission, the dedication.
That's awesome.
Not distracted.
Good looking boy, too.
DJ Giddens tackled for a loss of a yard. It puts him back at 99 yards.
He's had some game. Ripped off run after run, and then get to see Van, who was injured in the last series, back on the field.
Now Van this season, 7 TFLs, 5.5 sacks. Wears that number one jersey, which embodies the player that represents NC State on and off the field. There's a big honor in wearing that number one jersey. Isaiah Moore wore it the last few years. Play action pass. Johnson shows off the cannon. Deep downfield, nearly picked. Aiden White, the all-conference corner. Two picks this year at 4 last year. Almost got it.
I thought he missed a golden opportunity early to go to Garrett Oakley, the tight end, but then he comes back outside. You gotta always think you're gonna get the football if you're an outside receiver. Run every route hard because you never know when your quarterback's gonna come to you. They're a little bit late getting to Johnson, but he got there.
Gotta remember, this is a K-State team missing a lot of wide receivers for this contest. Thin in the run department behind Giddens as well. Johnson, quick throw to the outside, incomplete. For Jaden Jackson, threw it behind him. There's White in coverage, and it's fourth down, and there comes Bloomer to punt it away. This NC State defense has come out a little different in the second half.
Yeah, they finally found an answer, trying to keep Avery Johnson in the pocket a little bit, not allow him to run, and then it's forcing him to throw the football, and just hadn't gotten quite comfortable yet. 8 of 18, 106 yards, and obviously the touchdown pass to Giddens early.
Let's see if Coit gets a chance. He won't. They've been putting it up high. A lot of respect for this return game for NC State. Coit came in averaging more than 10 yards a punt return. I cannot wait for this one Saturday night in Dallas.
Lions.
This is
potentially a playoff preview, maybe a divisional round game, maybe conference championship.
It takes me back to the early 90s when we beat Dallas to move on to the NFC championship game. We didn't grow, but they did. And they marched on to 3 out of 4 Super Bowls. It's been a long time since Lions won the division, clinched it last week. First division title since 1993.
Dallas chasing Philadelphia. Obviously, you got the Niners and the Eagles in the NFC, but you know, what a renaissance for Detroit. Dan Campbell done a terrific job there. They've got an offensive coordinator who's going to be in demand in the offseason.
And done a nice job on defense with Aaron Glenn as well as their defensive coordinator.
Concepcion's kind of been battling through some stuff tonight. He's taken some big hits, took another one there.
You can tell watching him that he is not 100%. And that goes all the way back to the previous series when they tried to run and had him throw it on the move. Just did not look like himself. Kind of trying to battle through.
Interesting formation. Coit, the motion man. Armstrong will run. Impacted in the backfield and driven down for a loss. It's Bo Palmer.
Palmer stepping in there. He started the final game of the season against Iowa State. A couple of tackles in that game on the season 21. And they are not going to allow Brennan Armstrong to the outside or to make big plays again with his legs.
When Chris Kleiman and I caught up at halftime, he told me they had to take shots on Armstrong. They had to be physical with him, and the first half they weren't. You saw in that last play, they're going to gang tackle him, Andre.
Yeah, he was physical against them in the first half, bringing the wood.
K-State has its pass rush package out there. Armstrong to the air.
Nice catch.
And it's brought in by Gray for a first down.
Nice job of working the sideline, knowing exactly where you are on the field, and a nice tight out route. It's timed perfectly. Otherwise, this is an incompletion. And he runs out of room on the sideline. That is just rep after rep after rep. In practice, in the summer, you're throwing that thing, and he does a nice job of getting both feet down inbounds.
First catch for Gray, who's battled injuries this season. K-State creeping into the box. Armstrong gets rid of it quickly into the outside. Concepcion spun out, gets to the 40.
Boy, they utilize him. He is, I bet you when he gets back, it's a couple of ice baths. Not one, but a few. And then getting the cryo machine as well to further do it. But he's going to need a nice ice bath. He'll be nice and sore tomorrow.
He keeps getting dinged up. He's holding something, limping off, and the next thing you know, he's back in the game.
Making plays. Tough player. He understands they're shorthanded, and he's asked to be a big part of this game plan this week.
Low snap. Delbert Mims.
Wow.
Taken down behind the line of scrimmage. That's Desmond Purnell. Second time we've called his name on a TFL.
Mentioned that he's a local kid, but he plays the run extremely well. Just kind of has a sense for it, knows formations, studies the game, and that allows you to really, really accelerate through tackles and really get to a spot where you can make a tackle. Nice job there by Purnell.
And Mims, not an easy guy to bring down at 5'11", 220. On third down, K-State brings 4. Armstrong escaping. He's going to be well short. And the Wolfpack will punt.
Yeah, started his slide about the 40-yard line. So that's where they're going to mark it. Going to back him up a few yards and force this punt. One score game here as we inch closer to the fourth quarter.
All the things that Dave Doran talked to us about when we spoke to him last week, he said, we had a humbling loss against Duke, and we looked ourselves in the mirror. We talked about a lack of discipline, toughness. Offensively, started motioning more, huddling more, shortening the game, trying stuff like this. Trent Penix into the open field. Can they catch him? 10-5, touchdown, Wolfpack, fake punt.
I'll see you one, and I'll raise you one. My goodness, it's a day of the special teams in the Pop-Tart Bowl. A missed tackle by Max Marsh, who is playing center field on the back end. He is the last line of defense for Kansas State. He slips. Actually, it's another player back there.
Lockett.
It's Lockett that's on the back end. He misses or slips, and that gave the angle to Penix, and they just couldn't get him down. The big fella rumbling all the way to the end zone.
We have 90 rushing yards combined tonight on fake punt plays, and now NC State will try to tie it with 150 to go in the third, a two-point conversion. Armstrong is a runner here, is dangerous. Back to throw, hit, and down he goes.
Wow.
V.J. Payne, the safety, coming on the blitz.
Well, they got two really, really good safeties. And both guys should be back at Siegel, and now V.J. Payne starting to inflict a little bit. No pun intended. Or maybe I was. A nice job there coming off the edge and getting right to Brennan Armstrong. You know, he'll stand in there and take a shot. He took one there from V.J. Payne.
Now, the fun part about bowl games is all the gadget plays and the trick plays that you have in the bag that you rep and practice and then never run in a game. In a bowl game, we start to see some of those come out.
You run them. I like it. You're going to run a fake punt? Hey, we got one of those in our back pocket. Here you go. We got a ball game.
21-19, 150 to go in the third.
This is exactly how we talked about it this week playing out. Both teams equally matched.
Well coached.
Well coached. Both teams, if one goes and visits the other, how are you doing this? Defensively, they take on those traits. This is nice.
One thing that was very evident when we talked to both sides, there is a ton of mutual respect from one coaching staff to the other.
No, there's no doubt. You go see a team, you definitely respect what they do if you're trying to copycat them. And that's all coaching is in a lot of instances.
The College Football Playoff Foundation and ESPN celebrate 10 years of teaming up to support teachers with the launch of a new postseason initiative called Touchdown for Teachers. A $1,000 donation will be made to local schools for every touchdown scored during a bowl game. Visit touchdownforteachers.org for more information. Andre Ware, last night, Touchdown for Teachers had you slinging it again.
Yeah, slinging it a little bit. Got one to turn over from 20 yards. It was a lot of fun. A lot of fun. Down at the Texas Bowl in Houston, Oklahoma State and Texas A&M.
Avery Johnson off play action. Finds J.C. Brown. He gets free. A hurdle, and J.C. Brown out of bounds after a gain of 22.
That was a beautiful throw by Avery Johnson. Word on the street, too, Andre Ware can still spin it. Heard there's some video circulating around that he's got that tight spiral rocking still. Heisman winner, legend.
I throw enough baseballs around Cart with Z that it kind of keeps the arm in shape a little bit.
Yeah, you had some zip on that, man. You weren't holding back.
So you might as well throw it.
In the game, quick throw. That's Jackson. Stood up by White.
I'll tell you what, if he's able to hold on to that thing and catch it without the knee hitting the ground, boy, they had sold out with pressure, and it was basically just one-on-one with White and Jackson. Kind of finding a rhythm, Avery Johnson, in the passing game. There's a side of him that he was less than 50% at one point. Nice 10 of 20, 133 yards in that touchdown, but starting to come to life in the passing game.
He's run for 43 and to score as well. Fake to Giddens. Downfield, ball is tipped and incomplete. Jackson and Brown were too close to each other, and NC State almost came up with it.
Yeah, somebody ran the wrong route because you don't have two receivers in the same exact area. And I think the reason why Jackson missed it, he thought Brown was there, and Brown stops his route. It's just every too congested. Maybe Sean Brown ran them into each other, which is an even better job.
Big third down here, and it's the part of the field where If you get close, you think about going for it on fourth down.
And you got to be leery of Avery Johnson taking off with this baby.
Wolfpack
pressure.
Bring the blitz. Looking for Giddens, not this time. Sean Brown was right there early in the game on the opening drive. NC State brought the house. Johnson went to Giddens, who took it 37 yards for the score. Not this time.
Yeah, they're going to play field position here and go ahead and punt the football, but selling out on the blitz. And I don't think Giddens was prepared for that one. Sean Brown certainly was.
21 points in the opening half, none in the third quarter for Kansas State.
I like watching my man Beebe here.
Coit with the fair catch at the 21. Brennan Armstrong, at one point they had him at 129 yards rushing. They adjusted the stats. So now they have him at 117. He's done it with his feet. He has done it with his arm as well, 164 through the air.
And he's shown some toughness, breaking long runs and powering through defenders. He's actually shown some speed to break a touchdown run. He's set to maybe have NC State take a lead here.
First time in his Wolfpack career, he's thrown for 100 and rushed for 100. Gets it to Delbert Mims. Ooh. He's the hammer.
Man, and did he hammer V.J. Payne. Got the man adjusting his helmet when he's getting up. My goodness, they pull around. It's just one-on-one, and that didn't do it for Delbert Mims. He's still running through defenders. That's a tough run.
And that will be the final play of quarter number three. We've got at least 15 minutes to find out who eats the mascot, Kansas State or NC State. The winning team will devour a mascot Pop-Tart.
Coach, what's changing for your team offensively in this game?
Well, we're able to get a couple shots, move the ball that way. The fake punt obviously was a big play. We got to finish drives, and we've had too many field goal attempts. We got to get down the red zone and get some touchdowns.
What do you want to see from your quarterback, Brennan Armstrong?
He's playing really hard. You know, just keep doing what he's doing. I like how Brennan's playing. He's got to play a little better around him, make some more plays, finish drives.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Finish drives.
Second down, quarterback run, Armstrong. And he gets to about the 29. It'll bring up third down and two. K-State has defended the quarterback run better. NC State in the third quarter defended K-State's running game better. Hey, what do you know? Two coaches who are very well respected making the halftime adjustments.
And they respect one another. And the two stars in the game in the first half were obviously Brennan Armstrong and DJ Giddens. And both have been somewhat held in check here in the second half.
K-State had one of the best third down defenses in the country. NC State tonight, 7 of 13. Out of an empty look. Pressure. Throw over the middle. Incomplete for the 8th-year senior, Bradley Rosner. And it's fourth down.
Yeah, pressure got home. V.J. Payne. And sometimes it's better that you don't get the sack, but the pressure forces the ball out, and then it allows you to make a play on it. So you get something big just from the pressure itself rather than actually sacking the quarterback.
So Noon Kester, the redshirt sophomore from Waxhaw, North Carolina, to kick it away to Seth Porter.
Almost forced the interception there. Now both punters are doing a nice job.
No return on the fair catch. Ball on the 31. Our upcoming featured football lineup Saturday afternoon. Georgia and Florida State, first two teams left out of the playoff, will play in the Capital One Orange Bowl. Saturday night, Monday Night Football cometh early. Lions and Cowboys, potential playoff preview. And then on New Year's Day, college football playoff semifinals, first Michigan and Bama. We cap New Year's Day with Washington and Texas.
Playing for a national championship, was told that he shouldn't play quarterback, shouldn't be a quarterback.
That was the story.
That's just a foolish comment.
Out of Tuscaloosa, Jalen Milrow. And not much going on. It's going to be a loss on the play of about a yard. Devon Betty making the tackle.
It's amazing to me. Offensive coordinators, sometimes they can only coach a certain way and a guy a certain way instead of adjusting to the talent on the roster.
You look at what Chris Kleiman has done since he's come to Kansas State at North Dakota State. They ran heavy personnel. Two running backs, two tight ends, sometimes three tight ends. Well, now he's gone spread. They've gone no huddle. They've changed how they play. They've used tempo. He's evolved.
That's how you last as a coach. You evolve and you don't run something that you did years ago and you don't want to move on from it and change as the game has changed.
First down by Porter. And the other big thing that he did at K-State, which he didn't do at North Dakota State, was use the transfer portal.
He's a heck of a football coach. Told us he got his break because the athletic director, who's now at K-State, was at North Dakota State. Otherwise, he may still be in Fargo. But he got a break, got an opportunity, and boy, has he run with it.
NC State crowding the box. And we get a penalty marker. This is an offensive line. The linemen don't often commit penalties.
It may be tight end Will Swanson.
Offense, number 54.
Who flinched just a little bit. Tried to make it. He tried to sell it that he was looking one way or the other. And then the officials already had him dead to rights.
You guys are talking about Chris Kleiman, and Gene Taylor, the AD, was with him at North Dakota State. And when we spoke to him last night, Anish, he said Coach Kleiman makes adjustments as good as any football coach he's ever seen, between quarters, between halves, and to play to his personnel is one of his strengths as well.
Johnson dancing around, throws it away on the run. Andre
smart
in that spot again.
Smart.
He didn't force anything.
Exactly, because that's how you run into interceptions. This kid has yet to throw an interception. I don't want to jinx him and have him throw one, but three touchdown passes, now four without an interception. It's because of plays like that. You're smart with the football. You take care of it, throw it out of bounds, live to fight on second down.
And you got to remember, it's an offense. The line is intact. There is youth and experience all around due to the exodus of players. Their top receiver, Phillip Brooks, their slot guy, opted out. Ben Sinnott, their tight end, not playing. Here's Giddens. He doesn't get very far. It'll bring up a third down and long. And right now, momentum is on the side of this NC State defense.
Yeah, they have come out in the second half, and it's been, you know, the adjustments have been made from both sidelines, but NC State has really put it into a different gear here in the second half, playing a little bit harder and now trying to rattle a young quarterback, maybe force him into a mistake here on third and long. But you also got to worry about the legs of Avery Johnson.
Here comes the blitz. Johnson tries to check down for Oakley. It's incomplete. Fourth down. That was tipped.
Not sure who actually tipped it. It may have been Fordham, Caden Fordham, off the edge. They got a hand on him, but they're trying to find a tight end again in that situation. And NC State, once again, going to force a punt.
K-State tried one fake punt earlier. Bloomer with another high kick. And they have not given Jalen Coit a chance to return one today. 41-yard kick. No return. The Wolfpack with the ball and a chance to take their first lead.
Welcome back to the Pop-Tarts Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Mania.
You really wanted to read one of those this year.
I did, man. Yeah. I've only done it twice this year. You guys boxed me out on those. I like doing it.
NC State with the ball, a chance to take the lead. Dave Doran trying to get this team to 10 wins. They've got a great quarterback coming in. Grayson McCall will be the quarterback next year. Played at Coastal Carolina. This season cut short by injury. Head coach at Coastal Carolina, Tim Beck, Doran's former offensive coordinator. But for now,
It's on Brennan Armstrong, looking to bookend his collegiate career and trying to pick up a bowl win in his final collegiate game. A record-setting quarterback at Virginia in his first season with NC State. And that was a great throw just off the hands of Concepcion, who's got seven catches tonight.
Well, got to come up with that one. Need big plays, explosive plays, as Coach Doran talked about with Paul earlier. And that's well thrown. That should be caught. Hits your hands, you got to catch it. NC State, 9 plays of 15 or more yards. Some of those have come in the running game, and some have been big-time completions from Brennan Armstrong.
Armstrong will hand it off.
Nice hesitation.
And a nice pickup there on second down of 6 yards for Raphael, the true freshman, a Florida kid from Naples.
Is he there? Set up the defense. Got an extra block and then a couple more yards because of it, making it manageable here on third down.
Concepcion lines up in the backfield and now goes in motion. There's the blitz. Armstrong's got to kill it with the pressure coming. That was Javon Banks.
And Austin Moore just sniffed it out big time. He was right in the pocket of the intended screener. So there's nowhere to go with a football for Brennan Armstrong. That's just well played defensively. Just kind of smelled a rat. Get free a little bit too easily. And here comes the screener. Let me peel off. And he was right there in the hip pocket. They play the field position game, and Kansas State going to get the ball with some pretty good field position to start this drive.
Noonkester booms it away. Porter comes up, makes the catch at the 40. Running backwards, gets the edge. Room for Seth Porter. Tight ropes the sideline, needs one block. Cuts it across. Touchdown, Kansas State.
We may take a look to see if his knee hit.
There is a flag back inside the K-State 40.
His knee might have touched down, but there is a flag at about the 37.
During the return, the legal block in the back, return team number 89, 10-yard penalty from the start of the foul, first down. Media timeout.
Eric Pizarro called for the block in the back. It negates a punt return touchdown for Kansas State. It's still Wildcats ball on the other side with 10-12 to go in the fourth.
You buy Pop-Tarts and Capital One. What's in your wallet?
Let's go back and take. Oh, wow, having a little fun at Topgolf. Recognize that. But let's go back and take a look. Eric Pizarro, reserve receiver in the game, and that right there is what the officials call it. What you don't see is the tug of the jersey, the left hand on the back. It's the correct call, no matter how you want to look at it. Right there in the middle, and it does basically stop a tackle from happening. Officials got that one right.
It takes a 59-yard punt return touchdown off the board.
And a great camera work by our guys.
DJ Giddens, who has not been as effective in the second half, picks up a couple. 103 yards on the ground for the all-conference running back. K-State had to replace Deuce Vaughn. Giddens stepped in and put together one of the best sophomore seasons by a running back in school history.
Tell you what, Tony Gibson has decided, though, he is not going to let DJ Giddens beat him. So he has been stout in terms of keeping guys in the box to defend the run. And let's see if Avery Johnson can beat us with his arm.
Johnson just 3 for his last 11. And now we get movement up front.
False start. Offense, number 70. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Mr. Leviston, a left tackle, sixth-year player, who moved to tackle after the 2021 season. He started every game at left tackle last season and began his career as a guard. He's adjusted well to the outside.
And that is the first penalty on Leviston this season. LaJames White is in the game at running back, twisting, turning, and he gets nowhere. Just his third carry of the season. He's the de facto number two running back with Trayshawn Ward and Anthony Freas in the portal.
Yeah, he's a change of pace, kind of quicker, slasher type. Gonna find just some quickness and explosiveness in the running game. And they get young in a hurry after Giddens. White, a sophomore, and then Joe Jackson is just a true freshman.
And Jackson has only carried four times this season. Down their number two and number three running backs. Down both top tight ends. Lost depth in the receiving core. Johnson over the middle. Completes to Keegan Johnson. And the Iowa transfer moves the chains.
That's a heck of a catch. Climbing the ladder, securing it, and you got to go across the middle in order to do it. He keeps the route flat, which doesn't allow the safety to get in play. Otherwise, it runs him right into the safety and maybe an angle to break in front of it. It's a nice job and it's a heck of a throw in a crowded area.
Even though the numbers say 12 of 26 passing for Avery Johnson, he has not forced the issue much. Here comes Jackson. The Ole Miss transfer on the end around gets close to midfield.
Yeah, and to your point, he's thrown a lot of passes away. And throwing them out of bounds at the feet of receivers just so he can come back the next down. Not going to put this team in harm's way by trying to force the issue.
And you wonder how much of that is a product of not having your top two pass catchers, yeah. Phillip Brooks and Ben Sinnott.
You've worked a lot with those guys over the course of the season, and then all of a sudden you find yourself throwing the younger guys. We saw two receivers in one spot at one point in the game in the third quarter. All that factors in.
Play clock down to two. There's the blitz. Johnson flushed. Throws on the run. Had Swanson open, but it's underthrown.
Well, that's when he's got a hit. You escape like that now, you know, your total focus becomes hitting Swanson, and he's out in the flat area, wide open along the sideline. Gotta complete that one.
Kansas State on third down, just 3 for 11. White is the running back. Wolfpack showing blitz. Oakley motions out. Here comes the blitz. Screen pass. Jackson tunnels. He's got room to run. It's a foot race to the end zone. Touchdown. Jaden Jackson, 52 yards.
Come on back and celebrate with Garrett Oakley, who threw the block, and I think he's going to get called for blocking before the pass is thrown.
Holding, offense, number 86. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul, third down.
So that's twice now. Two plays of 50-plus, really, in this series for Kansas State have been called back. Two touchdowns of 50-plus.
I actually thought it was a decent block. I got to look at this again. It looked like a knockout block by Oakley. He knows the screen's coming. I don't know about holding on that one, man. I don't know about that.
And Chris Kleiman shares your sentiments.
I agree with Coach there.
So the tunnel screen for a touchdown called back instead. Another third down, another blitz. Johnson buying time. He's going to try to run for it, and he uses his legs for a first down. He made it look so easy, the long strider. Yeah,
that's the game today. That's the athletic quarterbacks that can make plays. It's a I mean, it is torture on a defense when you feel like, oh my goodness, we got him bottled up, and then the athletic ability. This is the game today.
Maybe
it's
some
not,
of it.
It's not from the pocket, you know, all the time. Now it's guys that can move and put pressure on a defense.
Maybe some of it is the hair. There's a little Trevor Lawrence to his game,
isn't
there?
The strength is in
my hair. Here comes Giddens.
Yeah, I don't know if Trevor Lawrence could pick him up and put him down like that, though.
He had the run against Alabama, remember?
I remember.
Lone Strider.
He can run, but I don't know if he has that kind of magic in his legs.
This guy's got world-class speed.
Boy, they have found a player. And Avery Johnson.
What does a game like this, win or lose, do for that man's confidence going into the offseason?
It's going to be huge. Just every situation that he's been in and having to play through, and just the maturity from the standpoint of throwing the ball away has been excellent.
Off play action. Giddens sidesteps the pressure. Rather, Johnson sidesteps the pressure, and then again throws it away. Nobody open, third down.
Come back and play on third down. And he knows the situation. He's not going to do that on third down. He's going to try to make a play because he knows fourth down, you got to punt it away. But on first and second down, boy, that's as impressive as anything else he's done.
The throwaways.
Taking care of the football, absolutely. Now, when you go back and watch the film, are there receivers open that he possibly could have gone to from a timing standpoint? Maybe.
Wolfpack again showing blitz on third down. Tony Gibson likes to bring pressure.
It's coming.
Play clock at two. At one. They get the play off. Slant pass to Jackson. Yeah. Incomplete. They might get battled with pass interference.
Had to. He grabbed him by the waist. I think everybody in the stands in this stadium was waiting on the flag to come out. Fresh set of downs here for Kansas State.
Pass interference, defense, number 7. The ball will be placed in the spot of the foul, first down.
Yeah, good inside position by Jaden Jackson. He gets a nice little bunch package there, and then, yeah, just grabbing a hold of him.
Kansas State knows the value of a touchdown here that makes it a two-possession game. They've already eaten up 5 minutes plus on this drive. And that's Giddens squirting free. And he turns minimal gain into a pickup of almost 8.
We're talking about the squatting and the power clean of Dylan McMahon. I wonder what Giddens squats, because he's been bottled up a number of times in this game and just refused to go down. A heck of a first half, and they decided, hey, we're going to pack the box and make it tough. And he's still finding a way to affect the football game.
Back to Giddens, the soft-spoken sophomore from Junction City, Kansas. And he gets a little closer. It's going to bring up third down and short.
That shows a nice show of respect there by Davin Van. Helping Giddens up. That's when you know a guy can play. He's showing a little bit of respect there. Good sportsmanship.
Andre, given the score, given the game situation, is this four down territory?
I think so. When you try to put them away, when you're in this situation, this close, absolutely.
A field goal. NC State can take the lead with a touchdown.
They're coming again.
Johnson. Moving the pocket, has to flush it, and now it brings up fourth down. The offense coming back to the line of scrimmage.
I'd like to see Giddens carry it there on third down, especially third and short.
What do you do here?
Go back to number 31. Give it to him. Or I'm going to roll Avery Johnson out and give him a two-way go where he can either run or throw it.
Yeah, this was a play call to try to win the game.
packed in there.
Giddens bounces off one offensive lineman and takes it inside the 15. Give him eight more. Savion Jackson made the play upfield. It's a first down for the Wildcats.
Where do they go when they need a big play, a money play? They pull Big Cooper Beebe and go right in that area to make sure that they get the first down. So you go behind your best side and your best player on the offensive line, number 50.
And he caromed right off big number 70 as well, Leviston. Offset pistol look again with Giddens as the running back. Give is to Giddens, straight up the gut.
Man, what a block by Beebe.
Woo.
Caden Fordham is going to feel that for a minute.
Will be a full media timeout.
Well, he works to the second level as well as anybody in the game. And there, they just pull him around the center, and he's able to carve out some yardage for his running back, DJ Giddens. 21-19, Kansas State.
Pop-Tarts Bowl, all a part of Capital One Bowl Mania. That edible mascot nowhere in sight right now.
Got everybody involved.
He will be devoured by the winning team. And then I guess next year we're going to have to find another flavor to be the mascot.
I wonder what flavor is he?
You would know better than me. We've established
that. The officials laughing. The policemen are involved. Oh, that's great.
NC State, before we went to break, used one of its timeout trying to save the clock. Shot for the end zone. Brown breaks it in for a touchdown. The freshman. That's the future for K-State. And this time, there are no flags.
What a throw. The timing of the throw didn't allow the defender to make an adjustment or a play on the football. I mean, what a heck of a throw. It's out of his hands before Brown's even ready for it. And Robert Kennedy III could not make a play on it.
This extra point is huge. If it's good, it's a two-score game. Tennant's kick is good. This drive started with a punt return TD called back. A tunnel screen for a touchdown was called back. Third time.
It's a charm.
A charm. Thank you.
Two really good backs and those two linebackers.
About the drive Kansas State just put together, 15 plays, 72 yards, taking up almost 7.5 minutes off the game clock. NC State with a nice return to get out to the 35-yard line. Well, fans, you do not want to miss this for many reasons. Don't forget to check out the ESPN app for the Capital One postgame immediately following the game. Andre, you're going to see the edible mascot get devoured.
I know you're looking forward to that.
I think a lot of people are.
Yeah, it should be fun. It should be fun to watch.
There's a lot of people watching with no vested interest in either team, but vested interest in the manner in which the mascot
goes
gets
down.
There's the blitz from K-State. Brennan Armstrong throws into coverage, intercepted by Parrish. First turnover of the game, and Kansas State, 2.5 minutes from Pop-Tart heaven.
Glad the officials let guys celebrate a little bit. It's the end of the season. It's a bowl game, and what a heck of a play there on the back end by Jacob Parrish. He told us he was good in coverage in terms of the corners, the best covered corner
on this team, and boy, does he play this one well.
He had two picks in a near upset of Texas earlier in the year. Third in the Big 12 with a dozen passes defended.
It's a good football team, Kansas State. Had a couple of bad breaks, but man, have they had a nice season.
Here's Giddens. Pushed out of bounds to the 20 by Aiden White.
Hey, how about giving some props to Cooper Beebe? I know, Andre, you've been big on him all night. Last year, he decided not to enter the NFL draft. In early January, he posted a Terminator meme on Twitter with the three words, "I'll be back." Wanted to play with his younger brother, who's a freshman, and he wanted to put his name in contention for the K-State Ring of Honor. He explained there isn't an offensive lineman up there yet. He'd like to be the first one. I think he's got a case.
I think he's well on his way, Kark. I agree with you. You talk about a guy that just mauls people in the running game, and he's been doing it all night, leading the way on a fake punt as well.
This time he paves the way for Giddens, another second-level block by Beebe, who's a two-time All-American and a two-time Big 12 O-lineman of the year.
Ryan Kelly was a name that I couldn't think of earlier, one of the best at actually getting to the second level at Alabama when he's there now with the Indianapolis Colts. Beebe, throw his name right in there. He is just solid in terms of getting to the next level, opening holes, and then sealing things off on that second level.
NC State calls a timeout. This offensive line returned largely intact from a conference champion a season ago, and for this bowl game, that's what Kansas State banked on. Hey, we've got transfers and opt-outs at the skill position. We've got a freshman quarterback making his first start at QB, Will Howard being in the portal, but we can ride this offensive line, and they have.
That's why they got off to such a great start with DJ Giddens, is because of the five guys in front of him.
Giddens, 150-plus rushing yards today. Kansas State close to 250 rushing yards. And NC State will take its final timeout. It's third down. Wildcats with a two-score lead with 1:43 left. And it's time now for tonight's Capital One player of the game. This was a hard decision. You got Giddens, who's got a 150-plus on the ground, a rushing touchdown, a receiving touchdown. But Avery Johnson made some plays in the second half.
He did. Two touchdown passes. He also has a touchdown run. And he's averaged over 12 yards every time he's pulled it down to run it. So he is our Capital One player of the game in his first start at Kansas State. Fans, you're going to hear a lot about this young man as he grows, matures. He puts on a little more weight, just gets experience at the position. We're going to talk a lot about Avery Johnson in the coming years.
Anish Shroff, Heisman Trophy winner Andre Ware, Paul Carcaterra on the sideline. Kansas State on the doorstep of a bowl win. And now it's Johnson, quarterback, keeper. It'll bring up fourth down. NC State out of timeouts. Andre, we've watched a lot of quarterbacks this year, and you've got the great ability to identify the guys that you think can be stars. Watching a full game of Avery Johnson today, what is the ultimate upside for a kid like this?
Well, you see the physical talent. It's obvious. And how he runs and the arm strength, all of it. But it's between the ears for me, not forcing it into coverage. He's not throwing interceptions, putting his team in harm's way. That is going to go a long way for Coach Klieman and this offense and Kansas State's program. They have got a guy they can build around, and guys want to come play with players of that caliber.
And Chris Klieman better watch out. It looks like they're going to wait.
They'll get him.
They had it ready to go.
He can't get away. They'll eventually sneak up and get their coach. It's been a heck of a year. Going to win 9 games. And a quarterback to build around. They'll miss big number 50, though. Cooper Beebe, but his influence has been left on this program, and he is he's left it all out on the field with his brothers, which is exactly the way you should finish it.
A fourth down and three, and the offense comes out there. Johnson out of an empty set with two tight ends. He'll run.
Big block by number 50. Oh, what a block by the big fella finishing things off. Gotta love it. And then give him the first down, big guy. What a block by number 50, the left guard, just kind of pulling around out in front of his quarterback, sealing things off. That's the way you go out. That's the way to finish a college career. Oh, man, what a pancake. Sean Brown kind of felt the end of that one by the big fella, Beebe. What a moment. Coaches work so hard, long hours.
Victory formation, Kansas State. And its first bowl game in the state of Florida. Victorious. 28-19, your final score. And they are hunting for Chris Klieman.
Trying to find him. Coach may be onto him, though.
That's the only drama left in this one. And that mascot, he might as well get a head start. They're coming for you.
Oh, I think they finally found him. They hunted him down. Nice. He accepted it, though. Nice.
Savvy move by Paul Carcaterra.
He stayed out of the way, dude.
To avoid the bath, Paul.
Coach, that's a first. Hat covered in Pop-Tart dust, then the Gatorade. The second half, you held Brennan Armstrong, their quarterback, to 4 yards after he had 117 on the ground in the first half. What was the difference?
We tackled better. We challenged the guys. We got a bunch of warriors that wanted to play this game. It's a great football team we beat. But we were going to leave this game a winner and let the legacy of our 2023 seniors end this game the right way. And I thought we did a great job tackling. And then we found a way in the fourth quarter to start making some plays and denting them a little bit. And we were able to get a couple big scores or a couple big drives late.
You mentioned the seniors. One in particular, Cooper Beebe. He comes back instead of going to the NFL. He closes it out.
Whoa. Another one.
Cooper, get over here. What does this guy mean to your program?
He's a Ring of Honor guy, which is a big deal at K-State. He's a great football player. He's a better leader, and he's a better person.
I love you, Coach.
I love you so much, Coop. Appreciate you coming and playing and playing your ass off.
That's what it's all about, right?
Cooper. What is it about this coach?
I mean, he's just an amazing dude. He changed the culture. You know, when I got here, I was his first recruiting class. To see how we elevated, man, he's just a great person. I love this guy to death.
Coach, what excites you about Avery in the future?
Well, I think you guys saw it. He's a special talent, sees the field. The game and the stage is not too big for that kid. And he grew up a bunch tonight, and it's going to catapult us into 24.
Thank you, Coach.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
What a springboard into 2024 and the new year for Kansas State. They've got a star in the making at quarterback, and they've got a bowl win to celebrate. K-State 28, NC State 19. Back to the studio now at Matt Berry.
This difficulty demands an ease specialist.
Yeah, that's me. Geico makes it.
By Capital One, the festivities down in the field are about to begin, but first, this message.
Where have you been?
North Pole.
Hey there, watch this. Boom! Oh, ho, ho.
What's in your wallet?
Let's go down to Paul Carcaterra, who is with Cooper Beebe.
Cooper, an amazing finish. What was it about this game that kind of turned the tides in the second half for you all?
Man, the young guys stepped up. Jace Brown makes a huge play in the end zone. You know, 50-50 ball, comes down with it, brings us some momentum back. Defense makes some clutch stops, and, you know, it's all-around team effort.
You're one of five offensive linemen that came back this season and that finished the job. What was it about that group that made you so unique?
Man, just the bond we have together. You know, our coach, Coach Riley, you know, is one of the reasons he came back. He was the OC. You know, we had to finish it for him. You know, we wanted to help his job interview, and that's one of the reasons we all came back.
Well, you did it, Cooper. Congratulations.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
He mentioned his offensive coordinator for this game, O-line coach Connor Riley. Riley called the plays after Colin Klein left to take the OC job at Texas A&M. And he called a fantastic game. Kansas State comes out victorious. We take a look at tonight's Capital One rewarding performance now.
Yeah, you look at Avery Johnson hitting DJ Giddens to get this game started in terms of the scoring. And then he just made play after play. Just magical from the quarterback position. Took care of the football, didn't put it in harm's way. I'm sure that's what the coaching staff talked to him about in bowl preparation. The timing of certain throws was well beyond his experience and his years. They have someone and something to build around in Manhattan, Kansas, and it's that young man, Avery Johnson.
They're going to go in to 2024 with perhaps one of the better quarterbacks in the nation, maybe the best quarterback in the Big 12. This is the part of the game, Andre, many have been waiting for. Edible mascot, unique trophy presentation. Take it away, Kark.
Thank you, Anish. Want to take a moment to congratulate North Carolina State with a fantastic 2023 season. But right now, it's all about Kansas State and the Wildcats. You all came from Manhattan. You backed up your squad and they delivered. So congratulations to the 2023 Pop-Tarts champion, Kansas State Wildcats. It's now time to present the game MVP, and I'm joined by Florida Citrus Sports President Steve Castino and the Pop-Tart mascot, Strawberry.
I would like to congratulate Avery Johnson as a 2023 MVP.
Where are you, Avery? Get over here. You got your first start of your college career at quarterback. You told me last week that you couldn't wait for that moment to take the first snap. What was this game like for you?
Really just being able to go out here and put on with all these guys that you put in countless hours of work in, man. I mean, this is just a lot of fun.
We got to give props to the guys in front of you. Cooper Beebe and that offensive line, they all came back this season and they finished the job. What was it like for you as a freshman playing with those guys in front of you?
I mean, this is a family, it's a brotherhood. You see all these guys came back. They could have opted out. They didn't have to play in this game. They care about this university. They care about the fans. They care about the team. That's credit to all these guys. I'm so happy I got to play with them.
Congratulations, Avery. Manhattan, Kansas. You've got a quarterback. And now it's time to present the 2023 Charles H. Rowe Trophy to the 2023 Pop-Tarts winning coach, Chris Kleiman, and Heidi Ray, the senior director of the Pop-Tarts brand, will present this.
On behalf of the Pop-Tarts brand, congrats. Congrats, Coach Kleiman.
Thank you, Heidi.
you want to say something to your fans.
K-State Nation, thanks for coming out. Go Cats, thank you. The best fans in college football, right up there. The best fans in college football. Thank you for following these guys.
Coach, you've led a lot of football teams in your life. And every season's a journey and it has a story. What was this team's story?
The legacy of the 2023 team, man. They weren't going to be denied tonight. We had a tough one to end the season, and we had an opportunity to regroup. We've had a really hard 3 weeks, but these guys never flinched. They never flinched, and that was a really good football team we beat, where a lot of guys played on both teams that had opportunities to opt out. These guys didn't opt out. These guys were wanting to win this game, and it was big for us to finish up in the top 25.
Well, you'll certainly finish in that top 25. Tonight, it's about the seniors. It's about everyone who stuck around. But what does Manhattan, Kansas have in a quarterback in the future?
He's a pretty special talent, isn't he?
He is.
And he's as humble as the day is long. And I love his competitiveness, but he always does it for the guys up front. And the fact that, you know, he's honoring those guys, and it's going to be the next group that he's honoring. It's fun to have a guy as humble as he is, but as competitive as he is. 2024 is going to be a big, special year.
Sounds a lot like his coach. Humble, humility, and tough. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you. Go Cats!
Once again, we would like to congratulate the 2023 Pop-Tarts champion, the Kansas State Wildcats.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the moment we've all been waiting for. For the first time ever, the first ever edible mascot. Take that, Duke's Mayo Bowl. We're gonna toast the mascot. It's the best way to have it toasted. It's full of three of your daily source of B5 Mints. So let's hear it now. Toast that mascot. 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 Congratulations, guys. Toast that mascot.
We'll always love you, Strawberry. R.I.P. to peace. Can't wait to eat you. There it is, the edible mascot for Kansas State University. The 2023 Pac-12 Bowl Champions of the World!
Hey, bro. Hey, dude. 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 Hey, dude.